Every given stock price is separate from the previous stock price. It's a buyer and a seller agreeing to a price. It looks like a momentum because you're looking at a chart, but there's no actual momentum behind the movement. Each transaction is separate and independent from the previous transaction. So the idea of calling it a momentum is a physical property. All stock prices, all asset prices that traded free markets basically represent the thoughts in people's heads. I'm willing to pay, I think it's worth this much. I'm willing to pay this much. I think it's going to go higher. I'm willing to pay this much. I'm willing to sell this at this price because I think it's going to go lower because I need to pay for, I need my money for my mortgage payment. So we have to analyze stocks using the idea that it's the buyer and the seller's decision that moves stock prices. It's the willingness of someone to pay more for a stock that takes the price up. It's really for someone to sell a stock at a lower price than it was trading previously for the price of the stock to go down. These emotional components show up in price action. Let me give you an example. I note that nearly all bear market bottoms in the past have occurred on major increases in five-day volume. Usually five-day volume is the highest in 1 year, 2 years, or 3 years at market lows. Now, why is that? Why is that? That is basically because there's some emotional involvement where people say, I got to get out of this stock. And other people are coming in and say, well, I'm not going to buy your stock unless it goes down to a lower level. And you find sort of a balance. But the point is, the data when you look at, while it seems it's reflecting economic data or market data, it's really just reflecting emotional data. It's reflecting the what goes on in the mind of the buyer. Because of mine and the seller. And this is not just retail investors. We're talking big institutions. We're talking about, you know, even the FTX and so on. You know, what went on in the minds of these people who invested in them who didn't do their due diligence? It was very an emotional extreme, emotional high. Bitcoin, blockchain, trading on an exchange, making money. And these are the things that show up in our indicators. So we use indicators like put calls, we look volume, we have ratios, assets to assets. These things aren't reflective of economic data or physical data. Is reflective of emotional data, and I think that's what turns markets, and that what gets markets to move. I mean, who can explain how for a number of years in the past few years Germany was able to sell 30-year bonds at a negative discount rate, negative interest rate? Does that make any sense in the logically? It makes it any economic basis. Could it have been predicted in the past? Of course not. But there's some cuckoo things going on in some people's heads. Either central bankers being investors and so on.